Welcome one more day to the Techno-Digital School. In today's video we will be looking at a very common problem that appears in Abaqus when we define a contact, and we also include damage in the parts, so that elements that fail are removed from the simulation and eventually the contact doesn't work. First, we will show how to solve the problem when only one of the parts is damaged, and then we will see how to solve it when both parts can be damaged. So, let's get started. To show how to solve this contact issue when we have erosion in our parts, I have prepared a script to generate our starting finite element model. To run this script, as always, we go to File, Run Script, and this is the script, erosion script.py, OK. And here we have our model. This model represents the impact of a spherical impactor here on the right on a plate. And we have taken advantage of the quarter symmetry of this case. It's a very simplified model with a very coarse mesh. We can see it here if we go to assembly and we click on mesh. We have very few nodes, so the model will run very fast, and you can even run it using the student edition of Abaqus. The projectile is made of steel and we have assumed is perfectly linear and elastic. On the other hand, the target is made of aluminum and we have assumed that it can deform plastically and it can also be damaged. If we go to materials here in this model, materials, aluminum, we can see that it is elastic with this Young's modulus, 70,000 megapascals. It can take plastic deformation. For that we have defined a yield stress or yield limit of 200 megapascals. From this point it will behave as a perfectly plastic material. And we have also defined the ductile damage. We could have used any other damage criterion, but this is the one we have chosen. So beyond a 60% of deformation, it will start to take damage. And we have also defined a damage evolution based on the energy, on the fracture energy the material will absorb before it's completely damaged. This is 50 kilojoules per square meter. Okay, okay. To effectively remove the elements from the simulation, in the fill output, we have included the variable status, so that this variable status will control when the elements are removed from the model. So let's click OK. And if we run this model, we go to Jobs, right-click, Submit. When the simulation is completed, as we can see now, right-click, Results. And let's see what happens. Let's rotate this. I will set the rotation center here so we can rotate it like that. And let's animate the simulation, animate time history. And we can see that even though at the beginning, if we go close to the beginning, let's go ahead a few frames. We see that the contact is working fine. We see that the projectile, this sphere, is pushing through the target. And if we keep moving on, the target takes a lot of deformation. We can display, for instance, the plastic equivalent strain, and it is taking a lot of plastic of permanent deformation. And at some point, there is penetration of the projectile into the elements of the target. Why isn't the contact working anymore? Well, actually, if we look a bit earlier, at this point, we have these elements here. They have a lot of deformation, plastic deformation. And if we move on, in the next frame, these elements, or at least this element down here, has been removed, has been fully damaged. So it has been eroded. What happens when the projectile keeps moving forward? The contact is not defined with the next layer of elements, with the next layer of faces of elements. So there isn't any contact in between the surface of the projectile and the elements inside the part. So let's go back to the model. Let's go to assembly and let's take a look at the interactions. The interaction that we have defined is a general contact, and we have defined this interaction based on a pair of surfaces. If we click on the pencil here, this window pops up, and this contact is defined between the external surface of the projectile and the front surface of the target. Let's hit cancel and cancel here. And let's go to the parts. Let's go to the part projectile. Let's look at the faces. So let's double click on projectile. And if we take a look at the surf ext, let's hide the elements so we can see the surface better. And this is the external surface of the projectile. So this is fine. The projectile is not being eroded, is not damaged. But if we look at the target and we go to surfaces, we see this surf front. We have defined this surface just selecting the front face of the part. We're not taking into account any other face inside the target. So how can we solve this issue? There are two ways to solve this problem. Let's look at the first one, which will be to define a contact between a surface, which will be the surface of the projectile, and nodes, a set of nodes with all of the nodes of the target. So to do that, we go down to interactions. Let's delete or suppress these interactions, so Abaqus will not use it anymore in this simulation. And now let's define a new interaction. Let's double click. And this interaction will be of type surface to surface contact. So let's call it surf to surf. Continue. And we need to provide a surface first. So let's click here on surfaces. And let's select the external surface of the projectile. We can highlight it here in the viewport. Continue. And the next surface that we have to provide can be a surface or a node region, a group of nodes, a set of nodes. So we're going to select that, a node region. And we're going to choose among the sets that we have. These are not surfaces anymore. These are sets that contain nodes. So let's go to target all. And this is a set with all of the geometry and all of the nodes of the target. Let's click continue. And in the next dialog, we can modify how the contact will behave. But for now, we will leave everything by default, finite sliding and kinematic contact. We could also choose penalty contact, but we will leave it as it is. Here we have a default interaction property that we have created. And OK. The interaction property, I haven't shown it yet, but it is here. We have just defined a tangential behavior, which is done here, tangential behavior, without any friction, and a normal behavior, which can also be selected here, like that. All the options are the ones by default. OK. And now let's test again this model. Let's go to the job, right-click, submit. And when the model is completed, let's right-click results and let's take a look at the model. So as we see now, all the elements have been eroded. Let's click here, let's click on animate, and we can see that the contact now is working fine. Since we have defined the contact between the surface of the projectile and all of the nodes of the target, there is no penetration of the nodes of the target into the projectile. Okay, that's fine. We can define a contact between a surface and nodes. But what if we consider as well the erosion of the projectile? What if this surface, the surface of the projectile, can change during the simulation? Let's see what would happen. Let's go to model. Let's modify the material, in this case, steel. In Mechanica, let's include first some plastic deformation. Plastic, let's say the yield stress is about 400 megapascals. And let's include also the damage. Let's go to Mechanical. Damage for ductile metals. We could choose any other damage criterion. Let's take the first one, ductile damage. Let's say the fracture strain is around 0.8. And we will not consider the effect of triaxiality or the strain rate. Finally, let's take damage evolution. Let's say it is of type energy and the fracture energy is 100 kilojoules per square meter. Okay. Okay. And let's see now what happens with our simulation. Let's right click, submit. And actually the simulation aborted. Some elements have distorted excessively. And this is because of the combination of erosion of both parts and the contact defined between them. So if we go to results again and we see what happened, we see that there is a lot of distortion of all the elements, but the projectile is also getting some erosion. And actually, if we look closely, technically there is not penetration of the nodes of the target into the surface of the projectile. But the softer behavior of the damaged elements of the projectile tends to distort them way too much. In fact, we can see how the nodes on the surface of the projectile penetrate into the target, which is a non-realistic behavior of the simulation. And we're going to solve it with the second method to define a contact between eroding parts. So let's go to parts. And what we're going to do now is to, for instance, in the target, we're going to create a new surface that will contain all of the faces of all of the elements, not only the external faces. So let's double click on surfaces. Let's call this surf all. And this will be of type mesh because we're not going to select the geometry, but we are going to select the elements, the faces of the elements. So let's continue. And all the elements, all the mesh is displayed. And we could select all the elements like this. However, if we do this, only the external faces of the elements will be selected. How can we change that? If we come here to this toolbar called Selection, this option here is telling us that we can select only exterior entities. So let's click and hold and select the first one, select from all entities. And now when we click and drag and close in the whole part, we can see that we have selected many more faces and many more elements. And that's because we are selecting both the exterior and the interior faces. So when we click done, we can choose which side of the faces we want to select. And since it's hard to distinguish which are the sides that we want to choose, either brown or purple, we'll choose both sides. Of course, computationally, it would be more efficient to select only a few faces or the faces around the impact region, close to this corner, but we will select all of them. And let's do the same for the projectile. Let's go to projectile, let's open projectile in the tree, and let's do the same. Let's double click on surfaces. Let's call this surf all. We will select the mesh to define this surface. Continue. And let's do the same. Let's click and hold here, select the first option, and let's click and drag to select all the elements and all the faces of these elements. Done. And again, both sides. Okay. So like this, we can collapse the parts, the materials as well. Let's put this toolbar up here. And let's go to the interactions part. Now we're going to hide this surface to surface type interaction. Let's suppress it. And let's create a new interaction. Let's double click. This will be a general contact type. So let's call this general contact number 2, because we defined another one before. Continue. And now let's select these surface pairs. It would also work with all with self, but it's a good practice to select only the surface pairs involved in the contact. So let's click on the pencil and let's take as the master, let's say, is the projectile, which is the stiffest material in this contact. So this will be surf all of the projectile. We can see it down here. And as the slave surface, we will take target surf all. We hit here these arrows, and here we have the contact pair. So okay, let's select the property int prop. Okay, and this is all, this is it. Let's submit the simulation again. Right click, submit, and with the simulation completed, we can right click, results, and let's see what happens. Let's rotate the model and let's animate it. As we can see, the contact is working perfectly fine. We have damage in the target, as we have always had in this model, but we have also erosion of the projectile. We have some elements of the projectile that have been removed because they have trespassed the fracture strain and they have dissipated all that fracture energy that we defined at the beginning. We could display, for instance, the plastic equivalent strain, and we can see the highest values of a strain around the damage or the eroded region on both the projectile and the target as well. So these are the two direct methods to deal with contacts and erosion at the same time. The first one is a surface-to-surface contact defined between a master surface and a set of nodes, and the second one creating a conventional general contact using internal surfaces of the eroding parts. And now, come on, put it in practice in your model, or try this one that you can generate by downloading the script that we have used at the beginning of the video. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.